She was not exactly sure what she roused, but she felt no danger from the being silently peering down at her. Quill had to hurry. The village gates would soon close, and night would follow. Night, her uncle often warned, was when danger was most present. But Quill preferred the stories of the magical creatures that woke to protect the forest.
What the fuck?
Thanks to her new friend, Quill had saved priceless grains from the hourglass. She raced to the door of the cottage she shared with her uncle, hoping once he saw her discovery, he'd lose himself in tales of its legend. Uncle Argus was watching the evening light dim when Quill burst through the front door of their cottage.
Uncle! Uncle, there's something you have to see!
Out past the bell again, he scolded. Quill, I've told you countless times.
I know, Quill replied, crestfallen. I didn't mean to worry you, but I found something strange and magical. Quill's hands trembled as she showed him the glass.
What is it?
She asked. A look of panic spilled over her uncle's stoic exterior.
Where did you find this?
Roared Uncle Argus. Quill had never seen her uncle so shaken.
Just west of the clearing,
she explained. And as soon as I picked it up, something started helping me. Uncle Argus followed her motion.
A reader. With you, here, right now? Quill, what you found is very powerful and very dangerous,
he said with great concern.
If I could take this burden from you, I would. But this reader has chosen. Even with the moon full and bright, I must go right away.
Quill pressed.
Where are you going? I can help. We can help.
No, he snapped. They'll find you and tear you apart. I have to go alone. It is for your own safety and for everyone here in the clearing.
His long, heartfelt hug told her he was heading for danger.
I'll be back before midnight. Until I return, I need your word you will not leave the clearing with that glass. Promise me, Quill.
I promise. promise, she said reluctantly, wondering where her uncle was going so deep into the night.
Hey, kid! Kid! Wake up! Hey, kid, over here! I know where your uncle went. I can show you. You're twofold now. Very important. Bring that glass and your sidekick, too. We're going to need them. Quill called out,
Hey! Starthing, wait!
Quill had never met a Starthing. In campfire stories, they often meddled in the lives of mortals. And when they appeared, mischief followed. Passage through the Eastern Gate was strictly forbidden. But despite her promise, Quill knew in her heart that Uncle Argus needed her. Quill demanded answers.
Starthing, you can't just barge in here with your riddles. Where is he? What do you know?
The trouble your uncle's heading for is the kind only you and that silent giant up there can get him out of. This way, kid, urged the Starthing. And don't forget to tuck your ears in.
Thank you.
Ah, shit. My gosh.
Just on the other side is the Mire.
The Starling assured her.
There's a good chance your uncle's still there. Did you hear that?
The Starling seemed anxious.
I've ruffled enough leaves in these parts. I can't be seen with you. I'll catch up with you later. Just don't go and die on me.
The fuck was that? No shit. Oh, I see, I see, I see. Oh, shit.
A whisper echoed through the trees.
Fought like someone who has stolen our champion's power.
A small, yet fantastical band of sprites emerged, surrounding Quill.
I'm Veda, root seer of the Mire, and you have crossed into our domain.
She sized up Quill with a rueful gaze, then turned her attention upward.
I sense you there, too. I have not felt the presence of such a promising reader in some time.
A youthful warrior marched forward. Rootseer, I'm prepared to honor our great champion's legacy. Rodent, give us our glass. Quill stepped closer.
Where is my uncle? If you've hurt him...
Silence!
Veda thundered back.
It was Argus who summoned us here, and now I see why. Young one, I'm afraid the trees hum of attack. Your uncle's been taken to the castle of your ancestors.
Quill's knees buckled as Veda continued.
Argus put himself at great risk calling for us. Your uncle once took a solemn oath to protect the glass of your fallen king. He is the only one left who knows where it's been hidden. The Arcane have long sought to wrest that knowledge from him. And you dare to cross into the Mire with our glass? Sarfog will soon burn through this forest looking to tear you and your reader apart. Unless, of course, you find them first. Take these. Weapons made for the mighty champion who died so that your people could live.
Quill felt its otherworldly power course through her.
Find your uncle, Twofold, before the serpent and its masters break him.
The warrior fumed.
Our glass with her? Rootseer, she's minuscule.
Come now. The reader has chosen its hero. We must let their story unfold.
Veda replied with a frost of finality and vanished into the shadows of the Mire.
Thank you.
was Quill's favorite story. How Sir Argus fought beside the Sprite Champion to seal this temple from the Arcane and secured the survival of their kinds. Simply standing in their heroic footsteps felt like a great honor.
Oops, shit. misses. Oh shit. No. Oh shit. What a dumb. Thank you. Okay. Okay. Damn it. shit. I'm trying to get him over there. Fuck. Thank you. Maybe that's what it is. Alright, here we go. Okay. Shit. trying. Thank you. Gosh dang, why do I keep doing that? I'm missing something here. shit.
Quill felt a swell of pride as she approached the Cavern River. Its guiding banks once led her people to safety after the Cinder Knight. Now, all these years later, she would follow it back. Quill's muscles ached, and her eyes grew heavy. She decided it best to set up camp and rest before journeying on to the castle.
Hey, kid. Good. You're alive.
The starling spoke as it circled the campfire. Quill gasped in shock as the starling unveiled monstrous wings and curled horns. It descended, talons gleaming.
Oh dear, I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm not scared, Quill replied. I just didn't know starlings were feathered.
This starving thing's gotta go, kid. The name's Adurin. No, we aren't feathered. Only me. I'm working on it. Let's just say, choosing the wrong friends comes with a price. But you seem like a good friend to have.
Thanks, I think. Quill readied her meal and paused to take in the strange winged creature who now called her friend. As a field of stars bloomed over the sky, their campfire conversations deepened.
He's all I have. If I lose him, I don't know what I'll do, confided Quill.
Adurin looked down at his wings.
If I help you find him, can you help me?
If we can,
we will, Starling. I mean, Adurin. Although Quill was far from the safety and comfort of her nook in the cottage, her exhaustion led her into a deep sleep.
Hey, Ghostface. A lot of folks have been waiting for a reader like you to return. I know I have. I'm going to scout the castle up ahead. Keep her safe, okay? For both our sakes.
Durin was nowhere to be found, but looming high on a distant bluff was the castle, a stark reminder of what mattered most. Quill drew a deep breath and readied herself for the journey ahead.
Okay.
Oh shit. All right. Oops. Let's see. Thank you. trying. Oh, you fucking shit.
She'd seen this view before, in a drawing from her uncle's library. Being here made her heart flutter, and then sink. If the story of her family had been different, this would have been her home.
Probably shouldn't have done that.
Durin was back.
Hey, kid. You took long enough. I found your uncle, but the Master Sentry's been activated. I'm trying to sort it out. This way.
My uncle? Is he okay?
He's alive for now. We must act quickly. As long as that Master Sentry is watching, the path to the castle is a dead end. Maybe you two can find a way to shut it down. And I'll, keep watch.
Come on, fucker. Thank you. Oh, no shit. Alright. Oh shit, really, son?
All clear, kid,
Adurin affirmed.
It should be a straight shot to the castle now. Come on! We're trapped!
Cried Quill.
Can you open these doors too?
Oh no, these? These are powerful arcane hexes. I can try.
Thank you.
shouted at Durin.
We have to get out of here!
I've made a terrible mistake. What is this place? What's that smell? Durin? I'm so sorry, Quill. I really am.
Really? You fucking bitch.
All remains still, save for a blazing shadow poised to strike. Quill's insides felt like quicksand sinking in terror at the sight. The shape lunged, metal crashed. And a Durin's light went out.
Well, you should have let me experience
that shit.
Quill's
beating heart drew Sargoth's attention. It was a monster of such harrowing enormity that survival seemed impossible. But then, the reader illuminated a break in the stone. Quill dove, the opening just big enough, and narrowly escaped the snap of Sarfog's fiery jaw. Instinct fueled Quill's desperate flee. The littered limbs of those before her served as haunting reminders that this was where so many before her met their end. Her adrenaline waned, trembling and anchored by a heavy heart. She slowed, stumbled, and crumpled to the cold ground. Quill had never felt more small and helpless. It would take an army to defeat Sarfog. Then, she felt a gentle touch of warmth and mustered the strength to look up. The reader was still there, expressionless as always, but unwavering in their loyalty. Quill felt the depth of their connection, the strength that came with being twofold. They'd come so far, together. My friend, I need your help. If we don't face Sarfog now, my uncle will die. And that monster
won't stop until you and I are torn apart. Will you stay with me and try?
Oh shit. Shit. Mm-hmm. go. Yeah. God dang it. I'm having trouble getting that way. Run. He kicked him. Yeah, you're like halfway.
Yeah, I couldn't have to get through that room.
I don't know, I don't remember what room you're stuck on, but I'll show you when you get back. Or when you come home or whatever.
Quill searched the silent halls.
Uncle? Uncle!
She called, but only her echoes responded.
Get out of here. If Sarfog finds you.
Uncle, Sarfog is dead. His voice trembled as he spoke.
The glass. The reader. You've bonded. I wanted to keep you safe from all this. It is not a burden you can bear alone.
I'm not alone.
I missed a lot of the things too. The little scrolls, yeah.
My Quill, twofold and strong.
He resigned. We're safe now, she assured him. Let's go home.
No, Quill. You've never been in more danger.
His voice faltered.
The Arcane do not end with Sarfog. The King's glass, hidden here in the castle. You must reclaim it.
Where? We're ready.
I guess there's one more thing to do, I guess. Hope so.
A promising beginning indeed.
Okay.
For so long, another has toiled to write an end for us all. But your bond with Quill grows strong. Your fates, yet still unwritten, are now entwined. And that gives us hope. Yes, your journey together is far from over. Rest now, dear reader. We'll begin again soon.
The dark wood falls before me with broken bow and blackened leaf. I stand where trees
meet the sky.